Yeah, so you lost hit points, you lost a shit ton of hit points. Two spells, you did a spell, you did challenge ability, but you got that back now. And two spells? One spell? Two spells. And you did two spells.
And 40 hit points.
And 40 hit points, yeah.
The wave ship was used also basically help me fill that hit points back up.
Yeah, that's
six hit dice. I'm now missing one hit point.
I'm missing 25 hit points.
So those. So that random occurrence did a fair amount, actually. Awesome. So, we are back to carry on. I hope you enjoyed the video from my... We'll finish watching the like 3 minutes of that later. And I've got more. We left off. You got a whistle.
A whistle with a dragon.
Whistle carved from transparent crystal. Resembles a tiny dragon curled up like a snail. You also got 50,000 experience and leveled up.
Yeah. I'm going to ask him if he can examine the runes on it.
Yes, you can have it.
I'll use my helm of comprehend languages to comprehend languages.
Cool. Helm of comprehend languages, does that actually help you read? Oh, unless you cast a comprehend languages spell for many
yeah.
worlds. Okay.
Yeah.
Cool. The name, there are the runes on the side of the Dwarvish, and you can see the name Knight Corner etched onto the whistle.
Okay.
Do I know of anything called Knight Corner? Have I heard of many?
Make either an Arcana check or a History check.
I don't need Mass either way, so. It's not a history check, I'm going to do a history check. Cool. 19.
It means absolutely nothing to you.
Okay. It's a dragon carp one, yeah?
Yep.
Okay.
So are we leaving this tomb?
Oh, not
this tomb, not the big tomb that we're looking for. Well, it looks that way. Our rogue couldn't spot the trap.
Yeah. Well, so we also patched in a bit too fast. I haven't wanted to have a look myself.
At what?
The traps. Anything dangerous coming up.
Yes. That's what he's for.
Did you check the donations while we were away or something?
Yeah.
That's really weird that mic's quiet.
Yeah.
It's really weird that it's quieter.
Okay,
so
it's got nine. What was it,
knights?
You're all my friends.
Knight Caller.
I'm here to protect all of you from getting hurt. My shield will help me look at the traps.
Yeah, I was looking at the trap, the floor to see if I could see anything, any way underneath and stuff like that, wasn't I?
Oh, yeah, that's what your 20 roll was.
Yeah. I was like, no, I'm not going to see the trap. Yeah, I rolled it just to see, so it was 35. I was trying to find if there was a way underneath the floor.
And I rolled a 1 and you did the crescent.
Yes. I made use of 2 stars. Wait, no.
So, you have a look at the mechanism. I need to go to the right page. Because you accidentally got an item from this book. Random chance. And you got an item from this book.
I'm okay with getting random magic items.
I don't want to draw a part on that deck because I know I'm going to get bored. Something like that.
Someone's getting bored.
We want to try using this song.
You are void. You are void. You are void. So,
don't worry, guys. I can get you back.
Mm. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
He can actually call us back.
I think you can just find our location with that.
Which can call you back. Apart from one of them, we're just finding the location.
So, those particular slabs, what it is.
Hey Sam.
Hey Sam. Oh, that's a lot better. Why is it better?
I just don't want
to be a bit more, but apparently that was
enough.
Enough.
Weird. Alright.
What the fuck, technology?
Yeah. I'm happy it's working.
Yeah.
So, you investigate the thing. What it is the stone slabs are unwatered. And all they do is their slight shift, triggered a mechanism that was like a series of cogs or whatever that led back to the stone slab and moves it across. That's it. There isn't any cool space or anything like that. It is purely designed to lock you in that room and leave you to suffocate.
Yeah, I was hoping there would be a way where they built it. It might have come underneath, but okay.
No. Sam and Sammy are interacting.
Oh, so they're not the same person.
Well, he might have got two accounts.
He may
have two accounts. They?
Well, if anyone's going to find this out for definite, it's you.
What? Oh, right. Sorry, I was picking up my phone. Until the sun's gone down a bit before
because it's quite warm outside. Let's wait.
I'm already starting to sweat, and I'm feeling like I need to have a drink.
Yeah,
can
okay.
I pull one of the rocks out the wall? Is it more? Can I just pull one of the bricks out?
Go ahead and make the strength check.
It's gonna happen.
You can just create a brick. You have a painter.
Yeah, that's giving up. That looks at 15, I think. But yeah, paint's 15.
Yeah, oh, sorry. Oh, I have that check, but I guess it's
15.
Still
15. Yeah.
Cool. You try and grip hold of worked stone, are unable to really get a good enough grip.
I
said it's
roughly worked, so I thought it
might
be easier.
No, I mean, there's occasional bits to grab, but nothing you can just pull out.
Alright. Okay. Should we go hide in the.
I think we go
hide. I thought we were in there.
I know, we walked out, didn't we? We got out.
No, I'm back in, that's why I'm trying to pull the stomach out.
Yeah, I think you've got in, we're debating whether we're obviously.
Oh, yeah, I'm sitting down inside.
Okay, well, yeah,
it's
yeah, like a.
Using rare frost on the opposite wall to cool create cold.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's how short rest until the sun gets to a lower
point. Yeah. Do you guys have to sit inside for
the next 4 to 6 hours?
Yeah, that sort of time.
Oranges? Oh, you oranges.
We still got another bag, it's fine.
Good catch.
Get that pro.
Nothing wrong with my throat.
Yeah,
everyone.
Say nothing wrong with
my throat.
Huh?
I'd be really fucking weird, I'm not gonna lie.
The one that you do that is so it's so awkward.
He said, if I peeled this without a meatball inside, it'd be all weird.
That would be
a fucking thing.
No
matter what the fuck I'm. Why
you touch it, it's a mimic.
Oh, that's something like that's a yeah. thing I saw the other day, like a picture of like a person checking under the bed for monsters, and he goes,
so
no monsters.
Yeah.
They just said they don't love him.
It's just in mimics.
Before you 10 out of 10 would watch again, what, the throwing of the orange or I don't know what just happened.
A mimic orange eats you.
No. It wasn't a mimic.
It was me! I hate you! Everything
so,
is my face.
6 hours passed?
6 hours passed.
I mean, should act like out of character. Shall I do an inspiring speech?
Oh, you could manage to do an inspiring speech.
Yeah. Which is, what inspiring speech are you doing, Nathan?
I don't know. Do you want extra hit points?
Oh,
well,
yeah.
I want to
hear whether I'm inspired first.
I want to hear the inspiring speech. You are going to inspire people properly.
Oh, I'm going to. Sir, we've found the hill, we nearly died, we've not found the stag, we've got to do better. You need to make sure you find all the traps. Keep us alive, you're doing pretty good. Keep killing things, that's all bloody useful. I'm going to avoid picking things out of the air anymore. We really got to find where he is, because he might be suffocating in a different hole. Forwards into the breach once more, my friends. That's how I do feel.
I feel rather put down, to be honest.
Yeah. You can all grudgingly take the speed box, I don't remember. Is it your level plus charisma one?
Level plus charisma, so 16 plus 3.
Temporary hit points.
19 oh. Temporary hit points.
It's not temporary.
Yeah. Yay. I feel all.
I pretty much said everyone was doing fine.
You are doing fine, but you're not doing great. You're not doing it.
Yeah, you're doing all right. I mean,
you're doing fine.
We're alive.
Yeah, that's about as good as we're gonna get.
We've told you multiple times. You need to work on your speeches.
But Sammy,
if you want to be a real member of his husband family.
Putting it simply, Sammy, he said, it's fine.
It's
7 out of 10?
I'll take that.
That's pretty high. It wasn't a 7 out of 10.
That's generous.
Yeah.
It's a pity 7.
Yeah.
A pity 7.
I'm going to give you a 7.
Shall I get like some Shakespeare up here and just like quote it verbatim at you? I love it.
So it's not him in the morning. It's probably now about 6, 7 o'clock at night. We're probably going to be going to sleep soon.
So, but 6 o'clock, you step outside. The sun is not bright. I mean, the sand is pretty warm. It's still hot out here, but it is not.
extreme heat weather.
Mm-hmm. I'm a class true seeing.
Okay. This, I need to borrow that handbook. Okay.
Give me true sight.
Yep, I want to check the particular wording for it.
I've got so much better eating than when I was young. I used to not actually be able to swallow them. I couldn't eat them for the juice, and I had to spit out the edge of the bowl. I could never manage it. It stopped when I was about 9, but it was never even like, I can't laugh.
Do you not like the orange juicy bits?
I love orange juicy bits.
What?
Orange juice is probably one of my favourite drinks. Yeah. But I could never. I don't know why.
I don't like wine, actually. I'll need to take a look at something.
In fairness, orange juice is actually one of my drinks of choice if I was going out of orange juice.
Yeah, but I have true saying.
Beep. There's some other stuff as well. That's why I wanted to.
Cheers.
Oh, that's
content.
All right, let's swap those back. That's the wrong fucking book.
Great for the bookmarks.
What's he got
for the bookmarks?
Order pizza, man. Jesus Christ.
Order pizza. Order it for us.
Yeah, order us.
Order us pizza.
Yeah. I'll send you the address.
You could
do it.
Do it.
Not if Sam does it for us.
This is true.
Yeah, we have to get pizza later. We're doing it anyway. We're not doing it anyway. We are doing it anyway, but it would be good if you did.
We're not doing it anyway.
Deception. 7.
Yeah, I think we pass.
I don't think we can. I'm not eating pizza.
Okay.
Done.
Nice. One donation, that's one forfeit.
I will consider that multiple donations.
Yeah.
For
well,
free
each
pizza.
How many
pizzas?
No, I mean, how many forfeits? And also how many pizzas?
I was more concerned about the food.
No, that's easy.
We are easy.
Yeah, well, pick
yourself.
Pizza. Like, we will do anything for food. Anything.
It's very little. I was 18.
You will indeed do anything.
I fucking do fucking food, man. I'd do so much for food.
You don't even want to know.
Anyway, so yeah, you've got your visions. Yeah.
120 foot.
Yes, you
will walk down.
Yes, you will.
Looking out for things.
As you walk down, echoes around the cave. There's a
from the dragon whistle.
Yeah. That wasn't even for food. That was just because,
no,
why
wasn't.
Not? Budget tequila suicide.
This is true, yeah. He didn't
really like that. Tequila was alright, it might be him.
That was pretty good tequila.
It wasn't actually like, it wasn't budget.
No. It was a budget for the suicide, though, because I didn't
have
wine juice.
lemon juice.
I just put a bottle of lemon juice up on my eye. Because that's so much smarter. Cool, so, you walk down from this other thing, you walk down sort of. Actually, you can probably see it when you get out. You've got out about like 20 feet, and you can see a possible entrance to another tunnel just shy of midway across this gravel. Huh?
How far away from where I'm standing now?
From where you're standing, it's about 100 feet away, 120 feet away.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Would have taken me a while to get that far on that point.
Probably, yeah.
And I got there eventually, but...
Yeah. Okay, guys, I can see another entrance. Now...
What? Oh, you're right.
Yes.
Where are we going?
The question is, we can either go in there today, even though it's getting late, and rest in the inside, or we can know that we found it, it's also to make sure there's no other things in case it's another trick.
I'm going to continue walking down, see if there are any other.
We're going to walk around the entire room to see if it didn't go.
Okay.
And I'm just along this path.
I
have to
go down. I think there might be another entrance we missed.
Okay, yes, cool, I'll go around the
corner. Alright, as you get to the end of the,
Black death! Black bits of wine!
Just button near the microphone, so I start getting gassy. My boyfriend's gonna pick it up in absolute clarity. Good pace.
Yeah, basically doing what we did first.
Okay. So when you get to...
I don't know what that was.
At the other end of the gravel sandy section, there is another tunnel about the same distance in as the tunnel that you found first.
Okay.
Walking around the hill, that is the only other tunnel you find.
So there's two more tunnels. One in the center and one on the right hand side.
Yep.
Which one should we try?
And how long did that take you to walk around again?
To walk around, it would have taken you 10 minutes.
So,
just because you're not actually exploring, you're just walking and looking, so
taking yeah, because I've just got my vision, like that. Nothing left. No.
Yeah.
Anything in the Imperial plane? No.
No.
It's 100 feet because he's straight through to see whether there was anything in the actual.
Nothing in the Imperial plane.
It's specified to get here.
Anyway, yeah, this seems to be.
Yeah,
I know. Should we check both? Like, one? Well, we can either check them now, or it's getting late. So
I think we check what's in there now.
So if we can walk, if we get trapped in by the last time.
Well, we can paint us work. We can paint us out.
That's true. We can paint our way out. This is the look we want to do.
Alright, which one? The one closest to our den or the next one?
I'd say the one in the middle of this one.
The one further away from the entrance trying to kill us.
Right. It's your boat then. Actually, it's both of our boats. Furthest away or middle? Middle
it is! We're trying the middle.
Cool. You gonna pick up another stick?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because your stick broke. Your stick got ground to dust. You're gonna make your way to the middle one again. We'll spend about 10 minutes creating this sort of little crawl space. You can't see very far into this. Everyone else can't.
Lights again.
I've got the same dark vision goggles.
No, I've got true seeing.
Yeah, you cannot see as far down into it as the other one, even with the goggles.
I'm casting dancing lights and sending them 60 foot out.
Okay, that's all well and good. Once they hit about 20 feet down, they disappear.
Okay, what do I see?
So
I mean, how much of my tree seeds are left? Lost an hour.
You've used it for about half an hour.
Yeah, about hour, so you've got about half it. what you can see, looking down, the rest of you can see right around the entrance where you are, is some sort of very unusual tunnel. There's very like bright pigments of paint and stuff that sort of just what you can see. you peering in.
God.
I need to clear my fucking throat out. Hang on. Black pudding, what?
The darkness.
Bright, brilliant colours are to be seen everywhere. The stones and pigments undimmed by the passage of decades. The floor of the corridor is a colourful mosaic of stone with a distinct winding path of red tiles about 2 feet wide snaking its way south down the corridor. No stonework can be seen on the walls or the ceiling 20 feet above, for some sort of cement or plaster has been smoothed over all of these surfaces and then illustrated. The scene shows fields with kine grazing, a copse with several wolves in the background, workers of various races and strange animal-human mixtures, pig-human, ape-human, and dog-human, going about various tasks. certain of the frescoes show rooms of some building, a library filled with many books and scrolls, the door of a torture chamber, and a wizard's workroom. There are chairs, windows, boxes, bales, doors, chests, birds, bats, spiders, and all manner of things shown on the walls.
Okay.
That's what you see.
That's a werewolf.
That's terrible.
That's what you can see. The rest of you see a little bit of colour about 10 feet in, and then the rest of it's pitch black.
Oh, this place is.
It's dark down here.
It's very colourful. Those of you who've got dark vision can see about 20 feet before you are unable to see further.
Yeah, I've remade my dark.
Can I see my 420 foot?
Huh?
Can I see my 420 foot?
You can.
Okay.
What can you see then?
What you just said.
That's
we're not
going to
go through yeah,
that. And you don't see the far end.
I don't see the far end. I can't see the other side. But
so what does all the part look like? I can't see. Just
it was just very colourful, wasn't it? Yeah.
There's multiple colours at half of it.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's just very colourful, isn't it?
All the way down has a red path.
Ah.
Looks a lot better than the other place. But
so we don't get any of the murals.
And do I see any like pressure plates on the floor, like a like in the last one?
All right, go ahead and make a perception check.
I can just see them.
Oh right, yeah, you see secret doors, don't you?
Secret doors.
Yep.
I can see magical traps. It says
magical traps.
Where is it? Notice secret doors hidden by magic, and you can see into ethereal planes. Oh, so I can't see traps. But true sight does that, I thought.
No, true sight automatically passes illusion checks.
Ah, okay.
Yeah,
cool.
So true sight means you can't be fallen by illusions. You see shape changes in the original form.
Okay, yeah, I can see secret doors hidden by magic. But yeah, so perception check. Nat 1. Which I can re-roll.
There's a
1.
Much better.
24. You look for the sliding pulleys. You're looking around, you don't see any more of those weird sliding plates. The floor is made of a slightly different material. Those were like big, like 10 foot by 10 foot slabs. They were huge slabs of stone.
Okay.
And this one is made up of a lot more smaller, laid out, mosaic type of thing.
So
okay.
You said there's a red path. So the question is, do we stay on the path, or do we not touch the path?
I'm going to poke the path with a stick.
I mean, I can't see any traps on the path, so I'd say we stay on it.
I poke it with a stick.
I poke it with a stick, sunblade, and push its flame to like 4 max.
Uh-huh.
Which is like 30 bright light, 30 foot dim light. So it's 15 more thing. There's another bonus action to send it to overtime.
You can make it 30-30, yeah.
So if I try that, does the darkness recede at all? Does it become black light to
me? The darkness recedes a small amount. You can see another sort of 5 or 10 feet. Whatever it is, it's some sort of just overlaying dinginess thing that just...
Is it a magic darkness?
How far away is it from us?
What?
Although you can see through it slightly.
Have
so.
We gone inside?
I haven't gone inside yet.
Yeah, so
do
you
want to check the other door as well?
Has someone got some rope?
Probably.
Yeah,
yes,
all
I do.
Ties together.
Okay.
I'm going to walk in 20 foot and then do the spell magic.
I mean, if we're going in, maybe I should go in because I can see.
Yeah, so he can actually see.
I'm going in 20 foot and
okay,
do spell magic.
Alright, what are you casting to spell magic on?
Huh? The darkness.
You got to spell magic on the darkness. Sure. Go ahead and make a
charisma
check.
That's 20 total.
That'll do it. It would.
definitely not a spell. Well, I try. I'm coming back.
Yeah.
At least it didn't eat me.
Next one then?
Well, yeah, which we'll I is if he can only see the path now, he won't do the path tomorrow.
You can do it again tomorrow, can't you?
I can do it again tomorrow, yeah. I mean, I can do it again today, but it just cost another spell slot. Oh,
yeah.
But while I've still got it, we might as well check the other ones.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, yeah, so we go to the other one.
And unless
not
anyone else
minutes.
Wants to.
What?
Let's go to the checkpoint. Let's see what our options are.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah.
So you go pull open the other one, spend your time doing so. you get the little crawl space again.
Bye!
Bye!
Have fun with the D&Ds!
Fair enough. D&D requires slurping.
Does it have that spell?
Yeah, that's why that spell is in there. D&D requires slurping, so the creature spell to slurp.
Pretty neutral.
I don't have one.
Yeah, you're off control.
No, you're lawful evil as a DM, always.
I'm not lawful fucking anything. I don't follow some fucking code. Fuck off.
Code of the dice, you absolutely do.
Huh?
Code of the dice, you absolutely do.
If he decides who wants the number that he's rolled.
Do I follow the dice? Or do I not? Yeah. Yeah.
He just goes, well, that's that one. He crits you.
More likely to do it the other way. No. I'm killing them. So I'm going to make that nat 20 and 1. And say I went missed.
Yeah.
The corridor before you is made of plain stone, roughly worked, and it is dark and full of cobwebs. The ceiling overhead is obscured by hanging strands of webbing. And at the far end of it, you can see a pair of oaken doors at the end of the passageway, which have got massive, great iron ring pulls.
How far is this part?
It is 30 feet long.
Oh.
Can you use your mage hand and just...
Can.
Yeah, go and open that door.
From where I am, before actually, am I the first one in? Because...
I don't think we need to go in.
Yeah,
you've made a cool space.
Actually, okay. Yeah, from the cool space, I use mage hand on the door and pull it.
Cool. Mage hand can move 10 pounds, right?
Yeah.
That's not moving that door.
But it did set off a trap.
Okay, fine. Thaumaturgy.
Yeah.
That would do it.
Prestidigitation
was only 35. That's 10 feet. I think Thaumaturgy does a much larger range.
Yeah,
Thaumaturgy
is
30 foot.
Yeah,
okay. Okay, cool. So you swing open which door? Left door or right door?
The left one.
Okay. The door swings open, and as it does so, the entire ceiling comes and collapses down inside the corridor.
Right.
And looking down behind the open door is a wall.
I'm
going to try the other door.
Yeah, just do the other door if it can get through open, like through the rubble and shit.
Sure, you mean you throw it open with enough force, there's just a wall.
Yeah.
Behind that door is a wall.
Well, I'm glad we can go down there ourselves.
Yeah. Okay, yeah. So, we go. So, are we just going to relax in the other one and go to sleep for the night? Because it's...
What time is it?
About 8.
Yeah, you're looking up to your exit time. Oh, it's probably like you're looking towards 10, towards 7.
What do people think? What should we do? Should we check it now or should we check it in the morning?
I'd say in the morning we're all rested.
I don't know, maybe we should just utilise the last few minutes of your sight to just check there's definitely no traps there.
Yeah, well, I can't see traps in the site.
No,
but I can see better.
You can
than
see
you
where you're going, so you can see to look.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, I use 25 gold.
Oh, that broke was a bit soft.
Yeah.
Oh my god, nah.
What do you think? Do people want me to go in there and have a quick look around?
Yeah.
Tie rope into the one that
looks close to you.
Hmm.
We tie rope to you so you can walk,
40 odd feet down there.
Wall slide out, the roof collapse. You sure you want to go in now?
Well,
you've always got the wish to get out of here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
These wishes are an incredibly useful tool. Why just kind of running away?
Well,
it's saving the life is worth the use.
Yeah.
But if the rest before we go in, no, the issue isn't that it might kill us. It's that if we go in, we're not going to bring it back out again.
That's why we only sent one person.
I can wish myself out.
How long has he got left with it?
About 5 to 10 minutes.
True seeing.
About another 10 minutes, yeah.
So if you get there, you can run that. That's why you said you had another one.
So you'd prefer to just rest now and we'll go in together tomorrow?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm okay with that.
Alright. Long rest,
Okay, cool. We'll go to the other one with the...
The one that's actually quite long and has actually got...
One without the fallen ceiling that we've actually checked out properly.
Yeah.
Yeah. Cool. So you're going to go sit in there and you're going to settle up for a long breath.
I'm going to take first watch.
I'm not going to bother asking that, because as you guys sit down and try and get to sleep, you find some sort of force pressing against your mind and is making it impossible to sleep.
Do I understand what it is? Help yourself to levitate.
Out of game terms, there is no ability to take a long rest.
I know.
What about outside?
Yeah,
should we try outside?
Sleep outside.
Yeah.
The desk.
Yeah. We'll just set up our bedrolls and show them the sand.
We'll try to sleep outside.
Yeah?
Yeah, outside you'll sleep. You just cannot sleep inside the two.
Sure.
That's a test for to know.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Huh. Wow. Yeah.
So we know now once we go in, we can't sleep.
That's going to be difficult.
Okay.
Don't
mind spells.
Yeah.
Cool.
Right.
So, first watch.
Further sleep with brevity, because nothing's going to hit you here. It's just me, that would just be me adding shit for the sake of adding shit.
I thought you just want to add 1d20 rolls to go in.
Yeah. That's why.
But you said it now.
Something is in your dreams. What? What the fuck is that?
I still got temporary hit points.
I don't know.
Go away.
Oh, you're not resting.
Okay. What the?
We've got 19, so just take 19.
Yeah.
Before we do this, did you have the investigation stuff?
Who?
The investigation stuff.
During before, you've already slept. The next day.
Yeah. What investigation spell?
I was asking if you had the spell investigation.
I have find traps. I didn't even know there was a spell for investigation.
Is this?
Identify, sorry.
Oh, right.
No.
That makes sense. No,
yeah.
No, I didn't think
so. Okay.
But you've taken a short rest with it.
Yeah, you've rested with the thing, so I'll tell you what it does.
Yeah, that's
what
So, are you ready for this?
Yes.
No.
There's going to be a lot of typing.
Oh, right.
This is your item, this is what it does.
Okay, what's it?
Be ready for this. Or write it, you could write it.
What item is it?
I mean, I've got it here.
You won't find it on D&D Beyond.
Okay.
You won't be able to get it. It's on D&D Beyond because
I'm going to type it up while you're saying it.
Oh, yeah, I don't have that book on.
Yeah.
I mean, I do.
You may have to think. If you blow the whistle in darkness or under the night sky, it allows you to cast the animate dead spell.
Huh, nothing to do with my right.
The target can be affected through up to 10 feet of soft earth or similar
material. Do you want spaces between all of that?
Oh, come on, I did try to space it!
Clearly not, because there are no spaces.
No,
it's just one long word, and it allows you to.
Actually, one word is it allows you to cast the animate.
The target will be affected through 10 feet of soft earth or similar material. And if it is, it takes 1 minute to claw its way to the surface to serve you. You can use that once every 7 days.
I want new spells.
So, yes. Soft earth or similar.
1 minute to claw out. No, we're not allowed to sleep, Sam. We actually can't sleep. Security will get pissed at us and we're not allowed to sleep.
Make sure actually.
Read up a bit, because I've got a little bit more to add.
Oh, so
the
one
is probably out
7 days.
And can be used once every 7 days.
Once every 24 hours, you can blow the whistle to reassert control over one or two creatures you animated.
One or two?
Yep, one or two.
Okay.
That's the full effect of that item.
That's a very useful item.
Yep. Well, maybe. Oh, it was brilliant.
You know, I could be
guys.
And I just
I think John probably wins that for pure dedication, talking to his aunt.
I was actually having a conversation.
Yeah, I've got a conversation with him.
Yeah. What? As you should have done.
Yeah. I'm kind of upset that I haven't managed to roll a one.
It's hard for us to roll ones.
Yeah, but I just want to roll a one and one, I think.
Alright, yeah. Anyway,
you're halfling as well.
Yeah.
Oh, you don't really roll that 1 and the 20 earlier.
Oh, yeah.
Oh. You said you can roll.
This is very true, you don't have to.
Yeah, you can want to.
That was a fun conversation, I don't know about you.
Yeah.
I had a proper conversation. It was in depth and.
I feel like there's a pun there, but I'm not sure where. So. You guys are going to that middle fib. You're just going to crawl into the crawl space.
Yeah, it will get in true sight.
No. No true sight. Alright.
We will die.
Who's taking the charge?
I'll be going first.
You're going first.
I'll
follow close behind, ready to heal him all.
I'll be third.
I'll go last then.
Cool.
And I'll be looking out to see if there were any traps in the path we're not taking.
So you're just looking around the room?
Yeah.
Around you. Cool. Go ahead and make a perception check for me.
22.
Cool.
If I do by chance see what it's about to be, whether I step or not, I will
see.
If I don't, I will drop. You said twist and turn, they might actually step around it, so that might see one.
Yeah. So, you guys are following the Trail of Mosaics. So you'd like to lit up your sunlight to max. It is generating 15 feet of bright light.
Mm-hmm.
No dim light at all.
I'm doing the...
Are you looking for traps or are you sending your dancing lights around?
I'm
on traps. I'm the same dancing lights.
Cool.
I'm stupid and didn't actually take light as well. That's a cantrip.
That's smart. You could have done that.
So... So you follow down the path. Originally, it starts on the left hand side of the tunnel. It goes forward sort of 10 15 feet before coming around to the other side and then carrying on in a straight line.
Hello, Inspector Devlin.
I'm just reading things. So, as you're walking, at the point where Maladin, you take a step forward, and as you do so, the floor disappears beneath you and you plummet.
I was ready to like hit him in the ship, like try and grab him with my reaction.
Sure, go ahead and make a. Let's make a strength check.
Actually, I probably wouldn't because I have the winged boots on.
Oh yeah, you have a flying speed.
Are you walking or flying?
Well, I would drop and then shit and start to fly, wouldn't I?
But you drop quicker. You drop really fast.
Oh no.
Yeah, but you drop like 200 feet in this game, like instantly.
You just want to teleport down 200
feet. It's the speed at which this, because of the speed at which this game. No, let's go. Go do a.
I'll do my thing to try and grab him.
You'll do your thing to try and grab him, and I'll make you make a dex.
18. A 19.
You make a dex save, try and get the thing off.
26.
You put dex paladin.
Yeah.
Right. So as he disappears, you reach out to grab him and discover he's actually got, like, no. Not weighing anything, because the wings on his feet are fluttering, so he's staying upright.
That's a really good job.
You can as you look down because it's only 10 feet deep. At the bottom, there are a series of spikes.
Of course.
How big's the thing?
The pit, now that it's been dropped, is about 8 foot by 8 foot. And the red tiles went straight across it.
Can you go and prod at the next part of the 8 foot? Like the bit after this trap to see if there's another
one? Wally's going to say, how about instead I cause Mage Hand and get to prod on the floor in 25 hours?
Well, if you can fly, you can prod with this foot.
Okay. It could be a trap
and just fly across the gap and keep walking under it and sit there, aren't they?
That's what I mean. So, like, go across and just keep pushing at the floor, and then
I mean,
if there's nothing, I'll jump
get
over.
A stick and poke it.
I'll try that. I should just walk over above where the trap would be.
Mm-hmm.
And then where the, I'm still using the sunlight with Max, or can I see to the red bricks continue?
Yeah, over the other side. You can still see the bricks continue over the other side. And you're also passing.
Hello, Sam!
Yeah, we asked about pizza. What the fuck, dude?
That's it.
Keep going.
You pass one of those like weird paintings on the wall.
Can we see these paintings as we're going down?
You can see where's ours?
Yeah, you said you'll buy us pizza, man.
Yeah, as you're walking around, the light from the sunlight is illuminating some of them. So you pass like humanoids with dog heads. Sort of with their hands clasped together in front of a door. There's, if you're passing it to this pit trap, there's a depiction of an iron door that confines some sort of horrid creature. As you can see, it's like one of those jail cell doors that's got the bars at the front. You can see the scaled and taloned hands grasp the bars of the window.
Mm-hmm.
That's what you can see. You want me to look out the other side? So this is all on your right as you came up to this. So you fly across.
Do these seem like they're like historical depictions or just like...
They seem like the paintings of a madman.
Cool.
Okay. So you've gone across the pit?
So I presume I fly across the pits to the other side.
Yeah.
You see the red bricks that carries on.
Yep.
I can see for another 15 foot, it seems to keep going.
Yep, keeps going.
So that picture of the sealed beast on the right, what's the left, how much is it?
The opposite, on the other side you can't see because it is outside of the range of the sunlight, if you're staying above the path.
Okay, what I'm going to do is I'm flying back to the others to tell them that the pathway does continue on. We need to find a way to get around over this gap.
I can jump.
Does the gap like cover the entire width of
It doesn't cover the entire width. There is a thing on the...
you can go around it.
Yeah, but the path does not.
Okay, I'm going to get my portal up out and sort of prod the bits you've got to walk on to get around that.
Okay.
Let's just jump over the pit.
Sure.
How far?
I can jump 30 feet. So.
Yeah, it's like an 8 foot wide pit.
Well, you can jump your strength score. Strength stat.
You can jump 9.
Which is an 8 foot pit.
Which is not.
Yeah.
I'll jump over. How do you measure jump? How about you jump?
Strength
stat. And how? What?
Do you just. Strength. Your strength stat.
It's the 0.
No.
Oh,
10.
10.
There you go.
So I'm jump 10. Okay,
jump
10.
Jump.
I can't jump it. I only have strength of 6.
Maybe you fly.
Cool, so you're just,
then
you fly over it, land, check the thing, and then it's fine. The rest of you are just jumping over. Cool, so you jumped over, you have landed on the other side of the pit trap.
Crash Bandicoot.
So,
no boxes.
That's, I'm going to see if I can see this. Because that picture on the wall is kind of creepy.
Mm-hmm.
Can I cast as a paladin ability, like, detect fiends?
Oh, the divine sense.
Divine sense.
You're using divine sense.
Divine sense. I can use it, equal to 1 plus 3. So I've got 4 uses of this.
So,
and it will tell me the location of any celestial, fiend, or undead in 60 feet of you. I know what it is, a celestial, fiend, or undead, and it's identity.
Cool.
So there is a name. to meet that. A gambling den. He gave us those trinkets to wear and told us all about that.
Well, these ones?
Yeah, exactly. We bought one. The treasure that's still escaped, right?
Yeah.
And then he ran off to go get it because he wanted a dowry gift. Because he thought that it was super worth it.
And now he's missing.
But what about the rest of us? Like, where'd they go?
I guess they're still in the top.
Oh. I assume so.
I'm still. Maybe.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Well, so. Hang on, the floor on the red path just fell away.
Sorry.
Should we still follow the red path or? I guess if you're flying, you can just keep prodding at it.
No, I could use my hand to prod it over the collar just in case that springs out.
It's not a bit grabby.
Yeah.
That
works. Okay, so yeah, so should I stop with you so I can see every shoulder?
On
the
email. Yeah.
Sure. I'm around him, so I'm only behind him.
How? Are you just walking? Are you walking off the path? Or
no.
So
it's just not fall off the path.
If you're doing a sort of leaning, would we count about each other's weight?
The path is right next to the wall.
Yeah.
So I'll be up against the wall then, and you'll just try to.
How wide? What, 5 foot?
5 feet is. You can get through. 5 feet.
Why?
It's not
5 feet.
Okay. It is about 3 feet wide.
Still, it's nice. Yeah. Still fair to kind of eyeballs. Especially because that's how tall we are.
What
you
were saying, Chris, I'm just asking how you're doing it. That's
all.
Go.
Nice, nice.
Yeah.
Cool. Yeah, so I'm now looking over his shoulder occasionally, just casting mage hand and keeping it 30 foot ahead of where I am. And just poking the floor the red. Well, no, at the edge of the light, I can actually see I'm poking the red.
So, you're poking 50 feet in front of you.
Yeah, 50. Wait, 20 feet in front of me or 50 in front of me?
No, 50 feet in front of you.
Okay, yeah, sure.
Because you can't see further than that.
Well, you said it's played lit up 15
foot. For him. Because he is at the centre of it.
He was at the front. Oh,
yeah. Yeah. So, for him it extends 5 feet, 15 feet.
Yeah.
You're 5 feet behind him, the effects of the room means that the range is reduced by 5 feet.
Okay then. Yeah.
So you can only see 10 feet in front.
Okay, yeah, I didn't know.
Cool. So you're potting. Nom nom nom. Bye-bye. I'm up. No, no, fine. So, you're keeping an eye out. Make a perception check for me.
Actually, yeah. I will as well on account, but actually, I'm not a point, I can't see.
Yeah.
Yeah, pretty much.
Can you check if the stem of your is advantage or some proficiency? Well, that's all one.
So, can't take out.
18 and the advantage is a 10. So,
what's the question? Slightly stupid.
Multiply by both is 19 total.
That's not slightly stupid, alright. But, as you're walking along, the path goes forward a little bit, curves up back to the other wall, and then curves back around again. The poking thing. You do notice the path avoids two more of those covered pits.
Just off to drove straight through the first one.
Yep. And then as you're nearing, sort of hanging on in, as you've got in sort of 80 feet or so from this entrance, again, you spot. In front of you, another one of those common pits, and then your finger, your mage hand, prods it, and it goes.
Damn, we're all fine because. Same sort of thing. He flies over.
Yeah, this is the same. It's the same size.
Probably
not.
Yeah.
Halfling. Do a halfling hop.
I jump and try not to jump over all of you.
Oh shit!
Ooh,
on the
head
trap, yeah.
So, you fall around again, and it half goes over yet another. Which gets pulled open.
Well, this one's a lot longer than the other.
Yeah.
So you prop that open. Yep, so you find another one of those things again, pops open, you guys jump across. And then you watch as the path splits.
Mm-hmm.
What you see before you, to your left, is a stone archway filled with a veil of thick vapours. The stones on either side of the base of a keystone protrude slightly from the stones around them. As you move to within touching distance, the left-hand base stone begins to glow yellow, the right-hand base stone orange, and the keystone 7 feet above blue. Additionally, that is to your left, to your right, on the wall before you is a relief sculpture of a devil face formed of mosaic tiles. The face has a huge over mouth, inside of which the space is dead black. Additionally, when you hit that fork, you suddenly notice a message in the runes on the mosaic floor.
Mm-hmm.
It wasn't there before. The message reads, Acerak congratulates you on your power of observation, so make of this whatever you wish, for you will be mine in the end no matter what. Go back to the Tormentor or through the Arch, and the second grateful you'll discover. Shun green if you can, but night's good colour is for those of great valour. If shades of red stand for blood, the wise will not need sacrifice aught but a loop of magical metal. You're well along your march. Two pits along the way will be found to lead to a fortuitous fall to check the wall. These keys and those are most important of all, and beware of trembling hands and what will
win. I need to write this down, because I'm not going to remember any of this.
It is a hell of a
pattern.
Sorry,
I'm not typing with that.
Acerak congratulates you on your powers of observation.
Actually, you're typing, so that might be easier.
Yeah.
Just gonna whip out the thing.
Cool. So make of this whatever you wish, for you'll be mine in the end no matter what.
Make of this whatever you wish.
I just got a very happy email. The flight stands are about to ship.
Yeah.
Go back to the Tormentor, or through the Arch.
and the second great hall you'll discover. Shun green if you can.
What?
Shun green if you can.
Yeah.
But night's a good colour.
Night as in.
Night as in darkness.
Okay.
Is for those of great valour. If shades of red stand for blood, the wise will not need sacrifice. Aught but a loop of magical metal.
Aught but a loop?
Aught but a loop of magical metal. You're well along your march. Two pits along the way. There's another, this one, and then one, two, three, four more lines.
Two pits along the way.
Will be found to lead to a fortuitous fall.
Fortuitous.
So check the wall. These keys and those are most important of all. And beware of trembling hands and what will more.
And
what will more.
More?
Yeah.
As in animal.
If you find the false, this one and the two more, you find the true.
If you find the false, you find the true.
Yep. And into the column hall you'll come. It's a damn long tag, it's amazing.
Yeah.
No, we won't.
Jesus Christ.
The Iron Men of Visage Grim.
The Iron Men of Visage
Grim.
Is that ED or just Visage?
Visage.
Okay.
Do more than meet the viewer's eye. You've left and left and found my tomb.
Oh, and then someone could die.
And now your soul will die.
Oh god. You just turned off like that.
Left and left and found my tomb. What was it?
You've left and left, found my tomb, and now your souls will die.
Well, that's pleasant enough.
Yeah.
So,
welcome to new stuff, John and Nathan.
Is that how they got last time?
Yeah. They didn't get that last time.
Wait, they got different.
Oh. Right, so leave that with you guys.
Splits, and what do we see?
So, the split, there's a stone archway filled with a veil of thick vapours.
Yeah.
The stones on either side of the base and the keystone protruding slightly from the stones around it.
Mm-hmm.
As you move to within touching distance, the left hand base stone begins to glow yellow, the right hand base stone orange, and the keystone 7 feet above blue.
Yep.
To your right, where the fork meets
the
left.
Yellow, orange, and blue. And I know that where the blue was, the keystone in the middle.
Yellow, yeah, so there's the keystone of the archway at the top, yellow at the bottom left. Right, and orange at the bottom right. And then you're forking to the right into the where at right at the end of the tunnel is a relief sculpture of the devil face formed of mosaic tiles. The face has a huge O of a mouth inside of which the space is dead black.
Okay. Well, that was in the centre, so that's what we say there. So you're the archery there.
The archway to your left.
To your left.
Yeah. Devil's face to your right, and that's the end of the corridor.
Okay.
And then behind you is just the walls that you've been seeing the whole way down.
Can you take a picture of that text on my phone so that I can just have the text so I can read it rather than what I think I've written?
No. Sorry.
Let me just take a picture and I'll send it to the group chat.
Yeah. That.
That's how it's written,
I think it's given various different information.
Yeah,
one of them is called the thing about a ring, a ring of magic mental.
Yeah.
I'm assuming if you go this way, you can pass it.
There's two bits along the way. How many bits did we come across?
Three.
There's
two bits along the way and back further.
Hang on.
Four.
I will tell you how many you ran into.
We found, two bits along the way that we found to lead to a few fortuitous four.
Look
on
the wall, see if there's a picture of them. Four.
Hang on.
So two of
them.
So
four's a
four.
You said check.
Maybe it must mean two bits back. It might mean two off.
Why the
bits.
Fuck have you rotated it?
Two drops. The other bits don't. And then
yeah.
It seems
what the crap?
What?
So check.
Well, you're going to find it really awkward to read it because my phone has just randomly rotated the image.
What?
I've written it all down. I think you should keep reading it out.
It's really annoying.
Yeah, that's completely. Because I took it this way up. My phone's just gone. Bleh. Pitched you past the mosaic went over the mosaic path went over three and there were two others that it went around.
Hmm. Okay.
So if you're brave, go towards the devil's face. Was there a night is black or is it blue?
Right.
So I think it's black.
No, it says go through the arc.
Probably further down than that.
Mental.
So
go back to the tormentor or through the arch and the second great hall you'll discover.
So we can end up two ways of going to the second great hall. Either you go back to the tormentor, which could be the thing in the painting.
Yeah.
Or we can go through the archway and the holes are very that seems to be there as well. And then you'll discover the second great hall. In said second great hall, we should shun green if we can. So whether that means.
Well, there was a green light, wasn't there? No, there wasn't a green light.
So shun green if you can, but night's good colours for those of great valor.
So maybe we don't want to be wearing any green, we need to get rid of any green, or when they're there, there might be a green picture or green tiles to need to avoid.
Yeah.
Get rid of green, but if you're brave, wear black or blue.
Night's good colour.
From
those of great valor.
From the pictures on the wall, then we look like a tormentor.
So
maybe one over there.
Someone that's like, lashing someone or,
Not really, the closest thing to that would be that the iron door with the scale character. There's nothing really tormenting anything like that.
Yeah.
If shades of red stand for blood, the wise will not need sacrifice, or but a loop of magical metal will well along your march.
You cut off the right hand side of the picture.
Yeah.
Did it? I did it when I took it. I had the whole thing on there.
Bad photo with that.
I don't know why I'm
the way will be found to lead to a fortuitous fall, so check the wall. These keys and those are most important of all, and where trembling hands and what will more.
Can you try and take a photo again?
If you find the false, you find the true, and into the
column
hall will come, and there's the throne that's keyed. The Iron Men of Visage Grim do more than just the king's eye. You've left them there,
oh,
and now my
to-do
is
not that bad.
Will die.
So is this like a grand breakdown of what we have to do to get the
yeah.
I think it's various, well, some of the rooms around the place actually, so like probably not all of them, but a few of them. If we enter one that's, I'm assuming statues made of iron.
I really don't want to go through the poisons to convey.
They say Visage Grim, so I'm assuming
it's
grim. What's grim?
I mean, the vapor is, there's an arch, right?
Yeah.
But what about the thing? That's a tormentor, isn't it? Or like, is it, look, it's
a devil. So there's a devil, so we go left to the arch, right? With the yellow, the orange, and the blue.
Yeah,
it does
say
green.
So
it's
a pitch black.
Pitch black in the mouth. The mosaic that's made out of like various colours. There's also the painting that stood out to us at the...
That's much better.
Yeah, fuck, I was why I didn't do it in the first place, to be completely honest. I'm very confused as to why I didn't do
it. It says go back to the tormentor, so
yeah.
We'd have to, that's what it means, it goes back. Did anyone touch that painting?
We didn't.
No. Of the door, no, because that door was right above the
hole.
Okay.
So we want to go back, so if we're going to take this as... like as a clue to help us.
The problem with that is if you read it, it says, go back to the tormentor or through the arch.
Yeah, and through the arch is the vapor.
Yeah. Yeah, so I'm assuming going backward means you can find the tormentor going the other way.
Yes, which I'm guessing could be something to do with the picture of the chain, of the cage piece.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
Possibly.
We can
it says fortune, two
well.
Of the traps will lead to a fortuitous fall, so it could sense. Like there's a way into another room by going down all these holes.
Well, this says the first light seems to mean like the second room. So it says the second great hall you'll discover.
Yeah.
Because this is a great hall.
Is it?
I would assume this long hall with all paintings and stuff like that. I would say that's a great hall.
I'd say it's a hall, but a great hall tends to be somewhere where people gather to sit.
This is the tomb of a lich.
Logically, not being.
Like, it was a very, very long hall with all like paintings and like colourful. When I saw it as well, it was very, very colourful.
Possibly,
So, do we want to go back and check that thing?
I think we go back and check the traps and we check that painting.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm. Okay. Because that mystery is dodgy as well.
Yeah. And then what do we make of the colours, the colour clues leading after?
Maybe that'll be clear later on.
I hope so.
Yeah, because at the moment it means nothing to me.
I mean, what's it say about red?
It says, if shades of red stand for blood, the wires will not need sacrifice.
So
all
I think
that's a loose magical metal, if you're well along your mark.
Which I think means don't follow red, which is on the floor.
It says it means don't follow red.
No, do follow it, because if red is shades of blood, you need not sacrifice. So if you're following red, you're not going to...
Yeah.
It's not going to lead.
Yeah, it says you're well along your march.
So you will sacrifice
a magical ring.
Do any of us actually have any magical rings?
Yes,
I have a magical ring and a magical bracelet.
I do not.
I have no rings.
Does anyone have any magical armor?
No.
Yes.
Because a loop of chain, I'll say a loop of chain mail would be a ring of magical metal.
Mm. Does the red paint or the red stuff go left or right?
What the tiles are partly defined, it goes both left and right. It leads to both the double face and the archway. It forks.
But this doesn't say, it only says the archway.
Yeah, so. I think we check.
Yeah, let's go back and check.
Yeah, let's check the paint and check those traps. Because if we can see down to the bottom and it turns out that it's not actually just for the planet, maybe it's like useful.
It says 2 will lead to a fortuitous fall, so check the wall.
Yeah.
At all of the things, but yeah, so if you just check the walls at all of the things to see what those paintings are at those specific
areas. It means 2 of the bits have a good drop, or after 2 bits, you know, 2 bits on the way. The third one, the one I originally fell into, is a fortuitous fall, and either spikes an illusion, or who knows. Right?
Yeah. Could also be that 2 of those bits are good,
what's
one of them's bad.
What's the 2 that we did?
There were 3, right?
Well, 3 in the whole.
There was 3 on the path, 2 that the path went around.
Yeah, 2 that okay. Triggered ones that went the path went around.
Then it says so check.
No. So let's trigger the 2 that the path went around.
Yeah. Should we check all of the traps and then the painting by the traps to see what they
we can work in a chart from that.
So maybe the colours as related to keys we need to collect. It says these keys and nodes are most important of all, blah 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 blah.
Okay, whereas
so maybe if you want to get them all, you have to shun green, but choose black. To get the red key, you have to like give away a ring, or if you can't give away a ring, sort of that's the choice.
So it says just keep away from green, but knight's colour is good. So black is good.
So those are great power.
So that's like bravery.
Very brave. Or
so maybe black's bad then, because you can brave to go in there.
Like a Cyclops or something.
Yeah. Red is like white. You need a magical loop, but you're well on your way. So that like it's the correct way.
Yeah.
But then this goes 2 ways and doesn't say anything about the devil's head.
So I think you avoid.
Going back to the tournament, so we check the traps.
Let's do
the
arch.
We all want to avoid the arch. So.
Basically.
Okay, so you're gonna go back up, throw in the path again. You're gonna check each trap. So
follow the path. Can I look at the murals on the wall? Because we saw the big people, the dark people, and the.
Yep.
The thing we're assuming is the tormentor, but maybe we didn't look at the rest of it. We were too busy focusing on the path. So can we look? Can I look to see anything else that could be out of place as much as the.
Yeah,
I
would also like to do that. Sure, go ahead and make a perception check. Anyone who wants to look.
Some of us are going to be even sure if we don't step off the path or into the traps.
Shall I lead the way then?
Yes, you do.
Yeah, I'll lead the way. But I'll be stopping at each trap and checking the paintings at each trap.
Yeah, one of those was going to be at the traps. I thought I would check.
I'll show you the painting on the wall to make sure there's
no.
Cool. So
13. Cool. So as you make your way back across, the last one you're going to, now the first one you're going back to, there are murals painted on it, and none of them are actually directly over the trap. And there's nothing that looks sort of like a tormentor. There's just, you know, some of the. It's the one that's the copse of trees with the wolves in the background.
Wolves torment sheep.
Trees torment earth.
Trees are green. Trees are green.
Oh yeah.
Shun trees.
Shun green. So that's what you've got over that one. It's actually just to get us to. We should actually just do the opposite of what this says. Go with green. Avoid red.
It says
you're well on your way with red, but we've had traps.
The glitch is just lying to us, really.
The problem is, what would it be like if we had come on in the red?
Well, there were still traps off the road.
They're going to be magic traps that we can see.
Yeah. Have we got to any of those traps that we hadn't activated yet? You'll go across the second one again. There's nothing tormenting, there's nothing over the thing. You'll find one, the third one, which is nowhere near a wall. It's right in the middle of the corridor. Nothing's painted on the ceiling. It's been plastered over.
But there's like spikes at the bottom of all of these.
If you open this one, yeah, there's spikes at the bottom of it.
Okay.
But all the traps we've opened, there's been spikes.
Spikes at the bottom, yeah.
Even the ones off the red path.
Yep.
And then you come to, when you get to the fourth one, which was the second one, sort of back against the wall, you open this one, and yeah, there's spikes at the bottom of it, there's no tormenting, painting or anything. And then you come back to the very first one you walked up that had that.
the hands over it.
Examine that one in detail.
That one has closed again.
Yeah.
Which the others have not.
Okay. Can we agree
can I
additionally, what
sorry.
You can see is on the other side of this, you walked past the jackal, the like dog-headed people, which are clasping their hands together. But what you can now is a part of that painting is protruding. There is now a chest protruding from the wall.
Seems like a trap. Just like this whole tomb, really.
Yeah,
well, you say that you can easily see sticking out the latch of this trap is a needle of some sort.
Do we want to reopen the trap?
Let's really observe if we can see any of the colours that might stand out to us.
Mm. Yeah.
Do we think the dog people are tormented?
So check the wall.
Are there any greens, reds, blacks,
whites,
blues? I would still like to check the wall other than the murals. Other than the murals themselves, other than the chest.
What are you looking for?
Anything of...
When you say chest, do you mean like a wooden chest, or you mean the chest of a beast?
No, there's a bronze chest now sticking out of the wall.
Oh.
When you walk past, there was a painting. Now you're coming back, there is a bronze chest sticking out of the wall with a poison needle pointing out of it.
Does anyone want to move 30 feet away and I'll try and open it?
If
do you want to check the traps?
Hmm?
Can I check the traps?
What, check the chest?
Yeah, from a distance.
Alright, cool. You know, there is a needle sticking out the latch of the chest.
Oh, okay. There's usually a piece of it.
It's about 3 inches out.
Okay.
So it's like the trap's already been triggered.
Or it's very obvious, isn't it?
Too obvious.
Yeah.
I said we move away.
Well,
maybe
that would
be more
open
to
the sacrifice.
Well, yeah, if you can open it at range, then do that.
Yeah. So, 30 feet away. Actually, I can't see it.
The chimes.
Huh?
The chimes. We've got two chimes. I've used mine 2 out of 10 times. You
have I've
got one.
I haven't used mine yet.
Just so Jordan has 10 uses.
Yeah.
Is it still it's darkness and obscuring?
Yeah.
We've got this magic pattern. Don't think.
Well, it's not red. It's off the red path, right?
So if we think
this thing is on the path. It's
on the red.
Yeah, you've got the trap door that has the iron door with the hands over it, and then this is the mural right next to it, which
so
the path also
goes trap, the floor trap again, or?
Yeah, so is it red in any way?
There was a door where they got their hands closed, and like parts of that door is red. But you've got the jail, the cell door has got blue hands, and the behind that there is the light, it's just black, it's painted black.
Because it says, like, if there's a spike, it says a loop of metal, if it's red, will be mean that we're right on our way.
But you think we're going to put a ring onto the spike? So
I don't know,
maybe.
A loop of magic metal, it says, but then will you lose it? And
I don't know.
Go back to the tormentor to the arch in the same way we discovered the shine green, nice and close down the arch. So, how many bits did we cross to get here?
Three. We crossed two, this is the third one to get here.
There's the one that's not been opened again.
Is the chest not on the other side?
The chest is on the other side, but it's closer to the entrance than
yeah,
the
so we've passed four. We've passed all of them to get to the chest.
Yeah, you've walked over the top of two, and you're standing before where the first one you walked into was, because it's closed, with the other one
to the far end.
So, two bits along the way will be found for each of the quarters four. So check the wall. So do we think this
could
this
be
chest four. Here is the thing with the wall?
Instead of four, instead of four. What you were just four, so check the wall.
Yeah, because
check
if someone's fallen, this is the one you fell at, isn't it?
Almost.
Maybe the fortuitous fall is this being shown to us?
The trap, or the first drop that we originally dropped into.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Is it still spikes or has it changed?
It is.
It's
quite.
Shall I trigger it again? That's my boss.
That's obviously the others haven't reset.
No,
yeah.
Only this one that's reset.
Mm.
So do we trigger it, or
which is why I'm hesitant to re-trigger it.
Mm-hmm. But, we were told for choice. I'm happy, and I'm not happy, but I will try this. And test to see if it...
Alright, before we do anything else, I'm going to take off my ring and put it on the spike on the chest.
So that's on the other side of where that...
You have to jump over.
Yeah, I'll jump over.
Cool. And take your ring off and put it on the spike. Cool.
Well,
Nothing happens?
Nothing happens.
Cool, I'll get the ring back on and go back.
Cool, dude.
Don't break yourself on that.
Just to satisfy my own curiosity.
Yep.
FYI, that was a magical ring.
Yeah. That's cool.
Nothing happens.
So we're going to try and
see. And then I pop back.
Who's the stick?
Huh?
I can use my mana point to poke it again.
Yes.
I've got my
port
star and I can poke it.
Let's check the trap.
Tap it.
The trap, yeah.
Yeah, so I'm
going to
tap the trap.
The pin one.
Yeah.
Cool. Tap it, and it doesn't poke.
Can I try and put a little bit of my
weight
onto
it?
I've
done it now. Yeah. Just put a little bit of weight on it.
Just hold it.
Yeah.
That's the picture of the devil the devil in the cage holding his hands. Has it changed at all since the last time we looked at it?
No, it looks the same.
And it's directly next to said drop.
It's directly, so if the drop was here, and this was the wall, it's there. It's right where that drop was.
Can I? I'm going to jump over to be next to him.
I jump back.
You jump back.
I jump over. And I'm going to invest the chest carefully if there's any other traps other than the single needle.
Sure, go ahead and make a deception check.
23.
There are no other traps.
Okay.
Just that needle sticking out of it.
I jump back over.
Cool.
It does say, beware of trembling hands and what will more. Do you think that means the hands?
But yeah, do you want me to climb and lock it? Because I can use my mage hand to climb and lock it.
I will see if I can
or I
trigger the drop.
Yeah, you're stepping on it, yeah?
I'm stepping
on it. Cool. Just stand on it.
Not exactly the heaviest of people.
Does it?
That's true, right?
Does it look like it's just floor now? Is it moving when you're walking on it?
And is it red? Is it the place where I went?
It's still red. This is the one that was. So it's still got that red path on it. It's exactly the same location as the very first one you stepped on. When you stepped on that one, it went immediately. This one
is not. Right, if I take my court staff when you stepped off,
and
tap it.
Yep.
Do you get the cadence of there being a gap underneath?
Make a perception check.
It's a 19.
Yes.
19.
Nope.
Shit.
Okay,
I'm going to have a look at the wall in line with this sort of square of tiles.
Mm-hmm.
Is it totally flush with the tiles?
Yep.
How far from here was the entrance to this hall?
From here? I mean, you can see that. No, you can't see that height. But it was, you went in 30 feet when you hit this trap.
Do we want to go back further to see if the entrance is still there? That's a terrible idea. And then we could open the chest on the other side and find it again. Yes, why not? Why not? Let's be safe.
I'll hop over and I'll fortunately be looking out for other traps that may appear, but also looking for the entrance.
Yeah.
So I'll go about 15, 20 feet and I should be able to see it from there. Yeah, you see, when you go that way, you can still see that way. Yeah.
I also hop
over. Best you know, that entrance was facing north. So going up this tunnel, you are looking north.
I wasn't sure.
Best you know.
Maybe those colours will increase
the
light.
That's what I was going to say. Yeah.
You're not keen mind?
Yeah, I always know which way is north.
Okay, that goes, you're looking north.
Okay. That's what I was asking, just in case somehow.
I thought you got
to tell him you had that.
Yeah, I did the first mention earlier.
No.
Oh,
no.
Yeah, I have keen mind.
You mentioned it to me. That's useful to know.
Yeah.
Very, very important.
Let me know how much time has passed. Which way's north?
Very important to know that sort of thing.
Yeah, that's what I told you. Sorry.
Who is that? The other thing. Yeah, you are back up there. Still north.
So do I see the entrance now?
Yeah, you see the entrance. When you go up like 50 feet, you still see the entrance.
Oh, sorry. Okay, right. The entrance is still there.
Okay.
We found it. The only assumption the colours is to do with the arch. So colours blue.
Orange.
Blue, orange. Blue. Blue, yellow, orange, and blue. So you can make.
Well, blue and yellow make green.
And yellow and orange.
Yellow and orange make a weird orange.
Yellow and orange.
So we don't want blue, we don't want the yellow, because it says to shun green.
So if we forgot that part of the message and then assumed that two bits along the way he starts talking about this picture here, this area. So the fortuitous support, maybe there's a way to open that drop, whether it's with a chime or if we can use these tools.
Should we open the chest
first?
What
does the it doesn't sound like
I think the chest is just completely equal.
Maybe the chest has a key to open.
If I inspect the floor almost where the trap used to be, can I see any way of maybe being able to put a crowbar under there or a mechanism that we could tamper with to do it back?
Make a investigation check.
Unfortunately, I'm not the best at this, so I've got 7.
You can't find any sort of thing. The ground is completely flush with the rest of the ground.
How wide are the trapdoors?
They were 10 feet deep.
Not the traps themselves, the floorboard was swinging open.
The actual depth of the floorboard. The ones that you found were maybe like 3 or so inches.
Make a point.
Yeah, alright, I'll make a 1 foot hole and make it 5 inches deep.
Okay.
So I know this is going to be a really awkward number.
Come on,
what square?
1 foot, 1 foot square.
Do you know, 1 foot square and. So it's three square foot to do inches, it's got 3 inches, yeah?
Yeah, cool. So you make a 3 inch deep, 1 foot square hole.
There's no
thing on the other side.
It's just a small dip.
Yep.
Okay.
Right.
Well, that's changed. Should we move over there and I'll try and open the thing and see if it gives us any use?
Yeah, well, if you can open it at range, shouldn't we just say dip?
I thought we were next to it.
We are. Alright, okay. In that case, should we move away from it?
That's what I asked.
Yeah, left.
Yeah, so we all go on the other side of where the trap was. And so I'm 15 foot. Actually, it was not exactly next to him this time, so I can see just as far.
And are we making sure to stay on the red path as we're moving about here?
Yeah. And then I cast Mage Hand to open the chest.
Okay, cool. You open the chest.
No cannons.
As you open it, that needle goes. The other side.
Okay.
So she's clean out the chest and down the wall.
Yeah.
Okay.
Sink out. Put the chest open.
Can I see into the chest from where I am?
No.
And of course, we're looking at a chest and then seeing up and down and into it.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'll go.
You have a look at the chest?
Actually, can you fly up and see if you can see into the chest first to make sure it's locked?
I go look at the chest.
Sure. chest is empty.
Right. Can I look for any false bottoms?
John, are you looking or feeling around or what?
Poke it with a dagger.
Can you use
that? Yeah, I'll poke it with a dagger and like feel around for any like false bottoms.
Sure, go ahead and make your investigation check.
9.
Hey, Siege. That's ironic. You don't find any false bottoms, but you do find a rod that protrudes vertically from the bottom of the chest.
And how long is the rod?
About that.
Okay. Guys, there's a rod in here, but I don't know what it does.
I'm going to jump over. And
there's no hole.
I'm going to use my gnomish ways and investigate the possibly magic item.
Sure, I'm going to make. What are you looking for?
I want to see if it's a magic item.
Go ahead and make an arcana check.
I was going to take a look to see if I can see any lifts, runes, symbols, or pictures that might give
me
any ideas.
Go make a perception check. Ah, dungeon be magic.
No? Okay.
19.
There are no glyphs or runes or inscriptions or anything like that.
Is it, so it's just like a steel cylindrical...
What colour is it? I mean, if you come close, you can see it. It's wooden, actually.
Oh.
Oh.
Shall I use the mage hand?
Oh! I dropped my ring on it.
It's about...
I dropped my bracelet on it.
Cool. You drop your bracelet on top of the rod.
Nothing happens?
Nothing happens. You slid the rod into a hole.
I take my bracelet back.
And it looks like it can be pushed, pulled, swiveled.
Tap it with the quarterstaff, does it move at all?
I mean, there's a slight movement.
Yeah, but...
Should we get that?
Make an investigation check for your...
Me?
You, yeah.
Seven.
Not now. you might be able to. Can't wait to tell.
No.
I'm going to check the wall. I'm going to...
Can I look where
very defensively, I'm going to go straight up to that picture of the demon.
Mm-hmm.
The chains. And I'd like to see if that picture can be taken off the wall.
Sure, make an investigation check.
So where did that spike go?
Out.
Did it actually go into the wall on the opposite side?
I can't see the wall on the other side, so you don't know.
But it's not investigation. So that is 14.
14? What you can see is it's like been painted onto, you know, some sort of plaster or cement or something. So the actual painting, probably not because you can paint it off, but you might be able to smash through the wall.
I'm going to use detect thoughts.
Okay.
Can I steal any thoughts other than these guys around us with dirty foot?
Nope.
Anywhere to put, say, a wooden rod in this creature's hands?
They're grasping the bars pretty tight.
What about with the jackals?
They've got one hand that's just down by their sides, and the other hands they have pressed together.
They have three hands?
Well, they've got two hands each. They've each got a hand down, and they're reaching over like that.
Does anything on the wall have bracelets or rings or circles? Or manacles, like.
Not that you can see.
I'm going to use my mage hand to pull the rod out.
You're going to pull the rod out?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm next to that. Okay. I can't get to it then.
Okay.
Should I move this part out on the mage hand?
Okay, well,
yeah,
we'll
move away.
Yeah, so still 10 from 10
back
on my hand. I am going to lift up, try and move the rod.
Okay, cool. The rod comes up very, very easily, and where that trap door, you hear it. Where it was, as it slams open, and it is now 3 feet thick and a 30-foot drop.
Am I dropping it? Because I was checking the picture.
You were checking the picture, but I'm also going to say...
You were flying, weren't you?
Yeah, you're at this point...
The flying only has the duration required to recharge it. It's
a
very long time, but I was probably only going to be using it to cross.
Well, I think I'm going to say you're going to be waiting a bit more prepared for what
it is. Yeah, I imagine you would have been notified
when you hear something. Yeah, I'm going to be lifting this up.
We should look at our floor before we drop the roof on it.
I'm going to consider you've got enough warning to just activate those boots and say flash.
Okay.
And
can't see the bottom? Oh no, 30 foot drop, you said.
Well, I did say 30 foot. I mean, technically, can't see the bottom, it was further than it did before.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. So you just dance and light to send them down? Is the darkness effect still. Is the dark.
Yeah, once they've gone outside 15 feet, you can't see them.
Yeah, you go down there, come back up and see
what
we
like. Just tie a rope to you?
Yeah.
Go for it.
Do you know what?
I'm also going to cast the Detect Thoughts again, and I'm going to tell him I'm going to be monitoring your thoughts. So,
if you hear to hear me,
have we actually noticed any? Maybe. But I'd also like just in case there's a magical shield stopping us from being able to hear you.
Oh, actually, I don't think you can do that, mate.
What?
I've got Ring of Mind Shield and kind of my thoughts, so.
I've got the hell of telepathy. So I can actually speak, but.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I'll to you.
Okay. I will have Sunblade on max output so I can see it again.
Gradually
fly down.
You fly down. So it's 30 feet deep. There's spikes again at the bottom.
It's just the spikes drop again.
Yep.
Can I look in the walls or check the spikes or anything? Any sort of.
Sure,
go ahead,
make
a perception
check.
Nice, 16.
With perception? Cool. All this is just unmarked stone, there's nothing on the spikes apart from poison.
Okay,
awesome. So, poison spikes at the bottom.
Throw away
as well, so you don't take a crap.
Spikes.
Okay.
Always get spikes.
Should we go to see if that's changed anything further on?
Yeah. Did the wooden rod get removed or something pulled up?
Yeah, did it come out when I pulled it up?
It did not come out, it just.
So have you flown the rod to the top again?
Yeah.
I'm going to use the mage hand to push the rod back down.
Cool.
Anything change?
The rug will not go back down.
Oh, right.
Alright, I'll tie the rope and.
Should we attack?
You were looking at the monster on the wall.
Yeah. Why? I'm going to take out one of the. I'm going to turn somebody. Are we using somebody to see right now?
Yeah.
We're using dancing lights.
I can do that.
So,
we both use dancing lights.
Yeah,
like,
so
yeah.
We've now got like 8 dancing lights.
It's all of them within like 10 foot each of us.
I'm going to take out one of the short swords that I've been picking up with.
Yep.
And use that to hit the wall instead of the sunblade. Because it's made of sunlight, so then it can actually smash things. I don't want to bust up my magical sword.
Yeah.
Hitting walls.
Okay, are you using the blade or the pommel?
I've got this nice quarter star.
The blade will snap.
So you crop on the picture, and it cracks.
Oh.
So it's quite thin.
I'm actually damaging the plaster, but another slam.
Yeah.
Cool. Slam again, it cracks a little bit more, but a little bit crumbles off. Let's pull down a bit.
See behind it?
Not enough to see behind it.
I'm just gonna like ready a ray of frost.
Cool.
I would
also
ready
a sacred flame.
I would also like just ready a ray of frost.
Okay.
We're all just standing behind you going.
Okay. Pommel's gonna keep pommeling.
So you're gonna pommel, it's gonna take you sort of 5 minutes or so, but as you do start to just it goes back like 2 inches or so. All of the frost stuff where that iron door was, it all breaks and it all falls down into the pit.
Okay. And
what you see beneath it after it's all broken away is a normal inward opening door.
So wait, how big is this door?
It's like a normal door size, so it'd be like
so that picture was.
Yep. All
right.
So
So that's what I had it as an image being sort of like yay big on a wall.
Oh no! Sorry. No, it was the wall.
I'm
going to
check.
All the murals are full. Like wall.
Sorry.
What color is the door?
Yeah. The door wasn't made of. Is there any surface?
What's its name?
It's a wooden. It's an oaken door.
Okay.
Brown.
Any
brown wasn't mentioned, I don't know.
Yeah.
I'm lost now.
Yeah. Well, I mean, yeah. Yeah. Do you want to check it for traps, I suppose?
Yeah. Rogan advantage does.
It's over a massive hole.
It's a little crap, but
traps.
Yeah, the door might still be
trapped. Yeah, but I can't get there to check it. It's over a big hole.
You can make it out. The hole's only like 8 foot deep. You can get within 4 feet of it.
If it was 30 foot deep.
Wait, no, sorry, 30 feet deep, but it's only 8 foot wide.
Is there a room after that?
But we have to step up the red path, yeah?
Yeah. You can just step up to the edge of the hole. Because the red path is next to the wall.
Oh, okay, so I can actually... Okay, yeah, I will shimmy along.
Yeah. You can't get right up to the door.
I'm a tie rope to him
if
in case he
does.
Yes.
Fall.
Thank you.
Go ahead and make a perception check. Look at the tarps. It's tarp.
Perception is 20. No, 22, sorry.
22.
23, because you're plus 7.
Oh, yeah, you leveled up.
Oh, yeah. I forgot that gave me a plus 7 next time. Ooh, that's useful.
I did not stay on the shot.
Go,
fuck this, douche.
Fuck this shit, I'm out. I'm out.
I want to know everything.
So, it doesn't seem to be trapped.
Doesn't seem to be. It doesn't look to be trapped.
Well, is it locked?
Do I know this? Actually, let's move away from it and then have him cast Formatone to see if it opens.
Okay, are we all good with that?
What?
Formatone to slam this door.
Does it slam it or?
It slams the door.
I could use my mage hand to open it instead.
Yeah, just do that.
Try that. Okay, yeah, remove away and I'll use mage hand to open the door.
Right, Frost is correct.
Have you got your
door.
Sword out again?
So lovely, yeah, let's see.
What do we see?
A stone wall?
Well, no, it's open.
Yeah, open away from you.
Yeah. Stone wall.
It just says, like, just a passage.
There
is a small passage on the other side and then another door. It goes about 10 feet.
Yeah, can you open that door as well?
Can I let in that door, that hallway, and then that door for traps?
That's going to be a little bit awkward to do because you're at a weird, pretty weird angle. You're not at the entrance of the door, you're 4 feet away from the entrance. So you can see the cave. You're not going to be able to fully check. I mean, you really shouldn't see the door, I don't care.
Can I go up to the edge of that door and then look in and see?
How? Because there is a hole there.
I was going to take a jump to the door frame.
Well, you just check the door. Where is good to check the door?
Yeah, you can check the door because it's only 4 feet away, but that corridor goes into the wall and there is still an 8 foot gap.
Yeah, but where he stood to check the door and then open it,
he was right in front of that door, wasn't he? No, because that door is over the gap.
Alright.
That door goes right into the drop. So he was on the edge of the trap.
Someone ties a rope to me, I can go in.
Oh, I need to go in again.
I can jump here, because there's a lot of rope already around. I can jump to the door frame and go in.
Do you want to prod the door frame with your hand?
No. There's a door, there's a 10-foot another door. I can jump to that doorway that I've just opened.
Okay, yay. Okay, fine. Go for it.
I'm just going to be ready.
Someone else hold this rope as well.
So two holding the rope, get back in.
Yeah, I'm thinking, like, if you start teetering, I'm just going to jab you
with
my quarterstaff.
Okay, so you're holding rope, I guess you're holding rope, and you're standing on the quarterstaff, so if he teeters, you're going to jab him in the back of the head.
Yeah, but basically, you jab him in the middle of the shoulder.
They say it's dexterity. I think dex check for me.
Dex? Okay. I was going to say acrobatics, maybe.
The dex check, because you're not really going to think you're just trying to jump onto something.
That's good. 3+.
You got some extra 3 for him, maybe.
So that's
8.
Plus 5, so 8.
8. So you jump over, land, and then start falling backwards.
Teacher,
you should make an attack roll.
An attack roll with my quarterstaff is a 20.
Hit.
That will hit, do some damage.
That's a d6
minus
1.
Minus 1. It's 5 damage.
BAM! As
he's like, get back in there!
As Lubar just bolts you in the back of the head with his quarterstaff. But it stabilises you!
Sorry!
Ow!
There's a little bit of blood.
Wow.
I knew you joined us for a reason.
I will investigate these.
Sure, but make a perception check, looking for tarps.
That was one face
26.
Off. That was one face off.
27.
No, I've got 19.
What's that, 19?
That's why I said it's one off.
Alright.
It's one face off the one.
That's really hard to read.
Yeah, that one is, especially with the light. Yeah, that's a 20.
There are no tops.
There are no traps in this bit.
Okay.
It's just a 10 foot. Sorry, 20 foot
yeah,
by
so
10 foot.
So then I go forward and I investigate the door. Finish.
Also not trapped.
And the door is not trapped either.
Okay, so should we go in?
I go back to the entrance.
Do you want to open the door?
And that's like, I'll use my mage hand to open the door, and if something comes at me, I'm jumping out again.
Yeah, okay.
So I'm going to brace.
Yeah, I'm ready with the rope.
I'm going to brace
so well.
One of the hard
there. I use my mage hand to open the door.
Okay, cool.
Is it inwards or outwards, actually?
Opens inwards, opens towards you guys.
Yeah.
Cool. Door is open.
What kind of snap up here?
Nothing.
Okay, it's open fine, nothing's gone wrong yet.
I'm going to send my dancing lights past
you. I don't have mine.
Are yours inside with you?
Yeah.
Okay, I won't.
I still can't see that.
So I see 15 feet.
Shall we all go in?
Can somebody come first?
I think you've got to go first.
Yeah, you're in the doorway.
I've moved.
You nearly fell off last time.
I'm walking into the corridor. Yeah, the corridor's 10 feet wide still.
Yeah, so I'm in the corridor. Wide, so you
okay. Yeah, I'm going to jump across to the doorway.
I'm going to be weighted to try and to grab people to make sure they're safe. Yeah.
Sure, make a dex check.
Yeah, that's one. And you haven't got something.
No, eight.
A donkey.
No, I'm trying to catch him from first.
You can do both. Go ahead and make a strength check to grab him. Make a
17.
That one.
Oh boy.
That was a D100 for me!
31.
But I did grab you,
so that's 5. Does that hit?
No.
Well, that one always misses.
What time is it? The only two.
What's with the most difficult magic insurance?
What did you say? 30.
31.
Tell a bad joke.
Oh, easy.
You want me to message you something?
Oh, because that's funny.
It's a really good joke.
And he said say me in purpose, and I was like, no. Because
that's what we're doing. I'm laughing.
My head is gone bum.
That's even worse. That's not bad, that's just cheap. How do you make an onion how do you make an onion cry? Peel it. Terrible, it's fucking awful.
Yeah,
it's a bad joke.
Yeah, he's done that. Yeah. But yeah, I got 17.
You grab him. Yeah, there's a pop eye grip across your arm. If you get pulled in, you're now safely inside the door.
Don't worry, I've still got your rope.
Hold onto the rope and we'll pull you in.
Chuck the rope over and then I'm going to jump anyway. Dexter.
I'm getting ready to grab him.
I will see ready to grab him.
Everyone else has got view forfeit.
Roll a D100!
It's 96.
Oh, that's on the other page.
Oh, that's the very last one.
It's the very last
one.
That's the last one.
I've never rolled more 20s tonight than I have done in this
game. This is what I just for all of you to do. The person next to you is a mirror.
Yes!
What?
Oh, that's great. You've got right on the people.
You need to do that hand. No, yes, and that's that. That.
I've got to take
a picture. You've got to cut his arm, remember?
Oh, God.
It's a tiny owl. And it's
a flat hand. How long is this for?
First, don't talk.
How long is this for?
I don't know.
I can't remember.
Let's say you're protecting you're being each other's mirror for like a minute.
Cool.
The other one didn't have a time frame at all.
So that's a 20.
No one's changing.
You
suck.
Oh, right, yeah. Sorry.
I'm wondering what it was the left one. It was the left or right?
It's just says person next to
you. Person next to you is a mirror.
So that's a 20.
You're doing bad. Okay,
I'm trying to work it out.
I'm just following that way.
No, you two are mirroring each
other. Actually, we should probably be copying. He should probably copy you. I should copy him.
Nathan by himself. So we're just doing what Nathan.
Okay, so fair enough. So that was a 20. So I'm guessing I make it over.
You make it over. Yeah, that's one way or the other way.
Why?
Because it's a mirror.
An instant ago, comes to life before your eyes. The creature flaps its rings and stares at you. Oh, my God, everybody, please roll initiative.
Fuck.
Roll initiative.
Oh, wow.
Oh, double 20.
Double 20.
Oh,
right,
so you do it.
One of each.
Yes,
in one of each
with that.
Yeah. Fuck, we all play everyone. The void I go, I'll pick one of each.
So, forfeit?
Forfeit to everyone.
Which one do you want to do first?
Why do we pick a card when we bump into something?
Because we can get something that can kill it. I can wish it away. I keep forgetting that wish.
Hey,
I wish you weren't here anymore.
Don't forget.
Neil will fuck us. He'll go, he's not there, he's down next door.
Don't forget about his comet. Oh, if he did your next encounter on his holy, he gains a level.
Oh yeah, do you want to kill this yourself?
What's going on?
Well, you on it. You kill the next thing.
What's in front of us? Because I was doing Instagram when
you... Oh, it's a statue that moved.
Cool.
Yeah, but you can't see it yet, but they can. He can. No one else can.
If you're telling me that's happening, then yes, I'm going to fuck that shit up.
Right, what would you want to do? Forfeit or death?
Yeah.
Which one are you doing first?
Disintegrate.
Let's do the forfeit first.
Cool, roll a D100.
57.
What did you say?
57.
We're gonna buy pizza.
Sam buys pizza.
Like Sam's not buying his pizza.
I don't think you're there anymore, Sam. But Sam buys pizza.
Oh, God. You picked that one.
Yes.
What?
The one?
Oh, is it that one?
Okay,
cool.
Yeah, can you just send the other
okay,
pizza?
You're going
to
need to do the next one.
No, we're going to do this one.
Yeah.
Oh, do your deck. You need to you just copy and paste it and put it on Facebook.
How many
Dory?
Two?
What?
Two?
This character's going to get
seven?
Seven. Oh, well, how many can I pick without being killed? All but two, right?
21. 20, yeah, 20.
I'll pick one. Which one would you like?
Oh, God.
I don't want any of them.
Oh, God.
I'm going to pick the one under this one. Yeah, that one. Don't be void.
Okay. What is it?
Key.
Okay.
Oh, key.
Key. The key to the system.
You have a key that unlocks all doors.
The handle looks impressive, but there's a mouthpiece, the key. Looks like
it's a hand. Oh. The key to a demon girl. Is this the correct phrasing?
No, it's not that one.
Is it not that one?
It's not that one.
Which one is it? Wait.
Oops. Oh, it's not that one, but that one will come in handy later.
That one will come in handy later.
Which one is it? Hang on, I'm going to come
check the chat. Check the chat.
Oh, yes! 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 Fucking yes! Pick one of those at random. Don't care which one it is, but pick one and send us this link. That is what we are doing.
We have to sing a sea shanty.
We're all together.
No, do you know what? A sea shanty is awful when you have to do it on your own. Doing it with people makes it somewhat less so.
Do it!
What's the key?
I'm getting there.
It matters a lot.
Just read it.
What number do you need to roll? What do you roll, man? There's no nice here.
You could have just told him one of our.
How much does he die?
Yeah, I know.
I'm just getting there.
What round do I get teleported?
What did you roll, Swin? Was it a 1 or a 20?
That one.
Which one?
That's a weird one. All right.
Done.
I'll put this link in the chat, and this is the one you see.
Joy. Rules.
Now, all of them are 11.
Oh, good.
Yeah.
That would be helpful.
Like, how does this go?
It's in another language. It's in Spanish.
Just do it to drink up cars.
That's how I'm reading it.
In your hands, Maladin,
giant key that wants the weapon,
forms a glowing longsword.
Oh dear.
That
is the Paladin longsword. The Paladin. No. Is this that one?
The Holy Avenger at some point.
The Holy Avenger.
It's fucking
oh my
hard.
Gosh.
In your hands forms a Holy Avenger.
Holy shit.
Okay.
Is this good or bad? I don't know.
That's good. That's like the best Paladin weapon in the game. Like,
that's good.
And what level does it make it things? If you're on something level Paladin?
17.
Oh, shit.
Quick, we need to power level you.
Well, we're about to power level you.
Yeah.
I'm about to power level.
Should have taken two classes. You've got to level up for the next one.
But we have to do a shanty, apparently. But I don't know how to do it.
So,
I don't know that
you've just got a Holy Avenger. But it requires a true note.
Oh.
We can have a short rest.
We can take short
rest. After this, maybe.
Yeah, maybe.
Right, what's she doing? Are we shooting?
Escribo
River.
Escribo.
Escribo.
Escribo River.
Hang on, I'm loading it.
We kind of need to know what we need a tune for it.
Drink up your heart and zero. Go.
Just do it to drink up your heart and zero.
I don't think it works.
It doesn't really fit.
No.
I don't want any fucking people.
In a round?
Fucking hell. Get in a round, that'd be deep.
That gets a big mess.
We're gonna go on gold.
Right, is everyone being lead?
100.
Gold
99.
98.
97.
This might be a lot.
We good?
You're not wrong, actually.
Actually, I probably should read it so I know what I'm about to sing.
I'm just going to read it as we go.
Cool.
Yeah.
Ready? Ready?
Not really, but yeah.
Ready? Do you want
to... I'm trying to read it. I'm trying to work out what sort of tune do you want to go to.
Fuck no,
let's
go. Ready? Three, two, one, go.
It's
Esquibo,
It doesn't do anything.
Yeah, it misses, yeah.
That's annoying.
It's one of the ones that when it misses, it misses. Instead, it hits a section of the wall behind it, which disintegrates.
Yeah.
Yeah, a bit of the wall behind the gargoyle just... But the gargoyle is still standing. Do you want to roll to see if you explode?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yes!
We'll remember this time.
No.
I'll sort of have the open on that 20, that I'm not going to lie.
Next!
Oh, I'm going to move away from him.
Yeah.
And dodge.
Yep.
Agreed.
I'm going to remember where I am and dodge.
Cool.
I heard him say it's a gold gun, but he wanted to fight on his own. I'm going to wait here. Yeah,
big gargoyle is swinging down towards Nubok. Zero has to do anything to it. So it reaches down to try and attack you with its claws and try and bite you.
I'm just going to pass. I'm just going to attack you.
That is a 12 and an 11.
Both of those hit.
Okay.
Wow, you've got no armor. Oh, yeah, you're a wizard without
dex. I'm a sorcerer without
dex. Yeah. 10. That is going to be. 15 points.
Oh, I should have given this advantage using my sorcery points.
15 points of slashing damage, and then I've got another attack, which you can still use your sorcery points on.
Mm-hmm.
Another attack is reaching down to bite you as well.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but I only get 5 and I'm going to give it disadvantage on the save next time.
You get 16.
You get 16? Oh, fuck it.
Yeah,
yeah, you've got sorcery points equal to your level.
Disadvantage, fuck you.
Okay. That's an 8.
That doesn't hit.
Yes.
So that will miss. That's it done.
Cool. Shoot, shoot.
Maladin, dodge. New bar.
Disadvantage on the save.
Right, now this, I guess it's key, right? If I heal New bar.
We don't try not to do anything. Don't do anything.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm gonna give it disadvantage, because I think that's what I can do.
What is it you're using?
Yeah. So I'm gonna want to give disadvantage and save it to can't be
existed. You can reduce that thing by 1d4. Oh damn it, you could reduce this thing by 1d4. And you rolled a 16.
Yeah. Well,
but yeah, just before it occurs, but yeah, it's just, I guess just doing that anyway.
Yeah.
You can roll twice on this biomagic table. Mm-hmm.
So yeah, I think it's
unless it's one of these.
No, I think it's one of those.
No, I think it's bend luck then, yeah.
Yeah, cool. I'm going to use 2 points to do bend luck and 7th level decision.
Okay,
so
roll the d4 to reduce its roll. What is it that you give things a disadvantage?
It doesn't.
Alright, that's cool, that's fine. What do you roll a 4 and broke dice? So that you made no difference. Roll your d4. Tell me what the d4 is. Don't worry, it fails.
Okay. 3, 6, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14.
It's got 52 hit points.
Oh, so yeah, it's an entire card, which
it,
is, he does one more with damage.
Yeah. So, it is dead.
Yeah.
And you level up. as this green thing just thumbs out from his finger, strikes it in the chest, and it just turns dust. Yeah. Would be at
my level 12.
Oh, yes! I get my level 12.
Oh, fuck. Yeah. Pick a spell you'd like to have.
I will do. Just reset my spells.
Do we actually have any viewers?
Yeah, so use the 6.
How many people are watching? 7 people? The fuck? Are there any of them, are any of them like actual Twitch members? If you click on the... yeah, the little icon that's got the 3 lines and 3 dots. If you click on that, it'll tell you.
I think Sammy said you were going to leave it on.
No, Sammy said you left it on.
I get my
Titan Scrolls.
Oh, that's a four names. So four names, and is that including the orcs?
You mean three inside of your
and Aether.
Which means you just
lost
it.
That's,
yeah, you can take them down.
That's including Nathan. So there's three people. Oh! Hey, Kirsty!
There we go.
So there's just three people who don't have a Twitch account watching, which is awesome.
Hello!
Hello to you people.
Hello, everyone.
Yeah, there's 700 viewers.
Only two of them are us.
Only two? We're not even the majority.
Yeah. What is going on?
I think you gave another meta magic as well.
Yeah, quicken spell.
So that's two level ups.
Yeah.
Maybe you won't be.
Next one will be a death.
Yeah.
Long overdue.
Yeah. Someone should have pulled the void that wall. So
yeah.
The way it's going, you've had about 10 cards, I think you've had. There's still a, you've still got 1 in 2 chance of it not happening, but then resets.
I can wish to level up.
You could wish to level up.
We could all level up. You could.
Yes, you could.
I could wish to get to the next stage of power with my cleric abilities.
That would be a better way of doing it.
Yeah. But then,
okay.
But then Luke would just go, oh, nothing happened. I really wanted to, yeah.
Yeah.
So.
You could just wish for that.
Of interest, when the gargoyle disintegrated, one thing that it had, didn't disintegrate, it had a collar studded with 10 gleaming gems around its neck. That when you do the thing, clatter up to the floor.
Being a gnome with the art, the guild arts and thingy background, I'll go check it for being magic and that.
It's just formed of 10 blue quartz stones, each of which are worth 100 gold pieces. There is no magic for it.
Oh,
yeah.
Who's got the bag?
We don't have a
bag.
I'm sure one of us had a bag.
That's the.
Oh, he's got the bag.
Yeah.
Yeah, we know where it's gone. What else is in this room?
Well, it's 10 to 9.
Oh, yeah, I know, well, no.
Can we go and find out what this is? We've got a break in that hour.
There's a bit of a rave going on.
Yeah, apparently.
Well, 3 hours and 20 minutes.
Well, we're starting to get
moved.
Is it really? How long have we been going for now?
It's nearly 9 o'clock.
5:14.
Five.
Total time.
Total time. Ah, okay, we stopped at 2 something?
2:15.
Yes.
We started at 2:30, was when we actually started, and we took a break at 5:30.
We started at 3.
Yeah.
We absolutely started at 3. Yeah. We did not.
30?
We were more than an hour late.
We were 2 hours late. So we started, it might be 3:30.
3:30 then, yeah.
Yeah, and we took a break at 10 to 6.
So, we started at 3:30, we've been going from.
And we do kind of want all.
5.5 hours.
Yeah.
The first one was 2. We had a.
Remember, you had to go for 3 hours.
Well.
Yeah.
Well, what's
the
phone
call
just before you recharged it, and that was at 10 past 6.
So, yeah, in this room, you've got. It's.
I just don't feel we're getting this. I think we should get this. It's very good.
I can do it.
You're in a 30 by 20 box room with. Excuse me, that corridor that leads out to the mosaic room.
Mm-hmm.
And at the southeastern corner, in that thing, there is a door on each wall.
Okay.
How much damage did I take?
15.
Can I, without touching them, just look at the doors, see if there is any sort of like, I don't know, see if I can see anything around them that might shoot out and stab me or, you know, some distractions.
Sure, make a perception check. Look at the cards.
Nat 20.
Would you like deck or ask the
deck.
Oh, man.
The person with the wishes.
Can I wish to only draw good things?
you certainly can!
I don't know if that'll work!
How many decks are you drawing?
How many decks are you drawing? I will draw 3 decks of cards!
That's all three of your characters.
104.
How many should I draw?
Come on,
oh, how many cards from a 22 card deck?
But below four. Four below. We've got a number between one and four.
Maybe. Pick a number between one and four.
That's not between one and four.
Depends on what system you use.
I'm using the hush system, probably.
Exactly, so I said.
That's the hush system, I think that's two.
No, that's B.
I mean, I was looking to.
That actually is a B.
I'm going to be the first person to die. Two was going to be.
I rolled a D4.
Yeah, it's two.
So you're 20,000 into this one. So you're 40,000 from 18 to 19 as well.
Yeah.
The 240. You're on 245 L.
Cool.
230. So yeah, I want,
yeah, 245,000.
So yeah, 45,000. I need 20,000 more. Sorry. Sorry. Right.
That is not trapped.
Cool.
4,600. No. I can't see any traps, guys. But I mean, usually it's you guys that.
Plus whatever we got for the gargoyle, which is very cool, I guess.
What do you want to do?
Huh?
What do we want to do?
What are we doing?
Well, I looked at the horse and I cut, and you see me go, hmm. Become wiser.
Become smarter, and I just go, hmm. I just suddenly learned a new spell. I haven't said I really can't decide. Right, come on, guys. I mean, what was it? Gate meteors or power kill times dot all win?
Not power kill.
Could power kill should not work.
So no, I mean, like time stop could be fun.
Except that you can't do anything that affects anyone else. Because then it ends.
You can still move stuff out of the way.
No, because you
can't interact with anyone.
Did you not take
the
late fireball? Delayed
no.
Last fireball.
Ah, that's fun.
Because you go time stop, delayed last fireball.
Yeah. Yeah. That's about it. It's time stop, delayed last fireball, potion. Go. Make a save. Welcome back.
And I got over here.
I think we can go with. I don't think Gain's going to be helpful. I don't think we
can go with
PS4. You can also.
Okay, fine. Wait, go for it.
You can also. You can do Glade Blast Fireball and then Glyph. And then set Glyph to go off when it gets hit by Glade Blast Fireball explosion. And it just brings out over like. There's a Glyph. There's a Glade Blast Fireball. Go ahead. It's coming first. And then Glyph there. Then I'm going to wander like 50 feet that way. Drink a couple of potions and watch the explosion.
Thoughts, guys, friends. But anyway, sorry.
I digress.
Yeah, so I can't see any traps on the doors, on either of them.
Can I look for any secret doors in the room? Am I looking at the walls or something?
Sure, make a perception check. Look at the doors. 101.
I got a 19.
Not quite.
There are no secret doors in this room.
Okay.
Do the doors have any markings on them, details, their colour?
No, they're doors, they're just wooden doors, there's nothing.
So, like, describe the room again to me, sorry, I was too busy looking.
20 by 30 foot block, apart from that little corridor that comes into them, where it leads back to the pit, that's on the eastern wall, halfway in. At the southeastern corner were two doors on each wall.
Just two.
On each wall? Sorry, one on each wall in that corner.
And we've just checked both of them.
Should I draw a hole in each of the doors so we can see through them?
Let's just open them.
Yeah, just open one.
Let's step back to the doors now and use mage hand on the door.
Which one? The one on the eastern wall or the one on the southern wall?
Southern.
Okay, you open the wall on the southern, the door on the southern wall, not the wall on the southern door.
Hey, I'm also on my boat out here before I know if there's an enemy running through it.
Not if you're using your mage hand.
I'm preparing a safe attack.
Yeah.
Because then it's just you're able to do stuff with it.
I thought I could it out. I thought I can't ready it, but I got it out.
Grab it out, yeah.
Whip it out.
So, you open the door. Inside is a small 10 foot by 10 foot room with a door on the other side.
For fuck's sake. Okay, go again.
And what about the other door?
Open the door to the left. The east door.
Yeah. Or should we take a short rest so you can attune to his weapon?
Just a 10-minute rest, 15-minute rest, sit down.
Yeah,
I go on. Yeah? Cool, let's actually take our rest at the same time. So, yeah, that works well. Those of you watching, we're going to put some mind videos on. Sit and enjoy us, that's what we're doing it for, because they're great people. We're going to be back in, I think we took about 20 minutes last time.
Yeah.
We'll be back in about 20, 25 minutes. We're just going to stop, get some drink, get some food. And we'll do toilet break, stuff like that. We'll see you back shortly.